Hey guys, we're in the shop here today and we're going to look at a topic that I think is going to resonate with a lot of racers here. Suspension's worst nightmare is bind. Let's look at ball joints and figure out how we can reduce bind in that area specifically. Let's go. We're here in the shop today and I'm here with Marshall Fager's longtime racer, and we're here looking at the ultimate ball joint. And really looking at suspension bind, ball joints are a key area in that we should look at. And Marshall, walk me through a traditional ball joint and why the QA1 ultimate ball joint is different.
Oh, sure. Well, the main thing is on a conventional ball joint or an OEM style of ball joint, there's a spring mechanism or a Belleville washer that constantly applies pressure to the stud. So as you drive your car down the road, that is creating a little bit of bind and keeps your ball joints from wearing out or getting loose over time.
And that's fine for a street car, right?
Yeah, but not really. It's not something that you want in a race car. What we're shooting for is a ball joint that can move like that easily. Mm. That allows your front suspension to move up and down real easily, lets you put the control in the shock absorbers.
Yes.
Versus having a bunch of bind in your ball joints themselves.
Right, right. And what's interesting here is, so we have a closure nut system that basically sets preload on the ball. So you can set that preload to where you don't have any slop in the suspension, but you're able to have that ultimate low friction, I guess, feel from the ball joint.
Exactly. It's very similar to setting a wheel bearing or your spindle nut on your front hub.
Yep.
You want it to be tight, but not overly tight.
That's a great analogy for that, actually.
That's what we're trying to do with this ball joint. We can get it set really loose and still not have any play or any slop to it so that you have the most low friction ball joint possible.
Now, what's interesting too now, so with that design, a racer can do maintenance at the track. They can maybe do some tuning at the track with different pins or different things of that sort. Kind of walk me through, you know, as someone yourself who has a dirt late model and you're racing, you know, most every weekend, how do you utilize a ball joint and the serviceability when you're at the track?
Oh yeah, definitely. Well, as we all know, like at a racetrack, if you end up having trouble, you need to be able to fix it quickly and efficiently. And that's one cool thing about the QA1 design. You can pop the stud out of the housing without taking the housing out of your control arm, which is especially helpful if you have a press in into a stock lower control arm. The other thing is, you mentioned the tuning. We have different length studs available. You can see this one's quite a bit longer than that one. And the studs are about $25. You can, even if you don't know exactly what you're doing, you can put a longer stud in your right front upper A-frame, your control arm, change your camber gain, change your roll center, and it's $25. It's about 25% of the cost of a tire. So realistically, it's one of the more affordable chassis tuning things that you can do.
Oh, absolutely. And you know, when it comes to pin lengths, we have, 0.1, 0.5, 1-inch longer studs. Our tech team can help people with that. That's no issue at all, in case you're not really sure where to go pin length-wise. But I'm glad you brought up the ball joint pins, because I think that's an area that I think deserves some discussion. You know, some of the things that I've seen, just from, a casual watcher is, you'll see racers, especially in circle track, where they might wash up the track into the wall, or they get into another car, or they get into an accident type event at the track, right?
Yep.
Some ball joints I've witnessed shear off and break.
Yeah, I mean, ultimately we're trying not to hit anybody, but as we all know, it happens. And that's where QA1 has spent a lot of time getting the heat treating dialed in on these studs. So it's designed where the ball of the stud is extremely tough and heat treated. And as we go up the shank or down the shank on a lower, we taper that heat treating down a little bit. And the design there is, if you do get into a hard impact, wheel-to-wheel contact, or you brush the wall, the stud is actually designed to bend versus shearing off.
So your name won't have a DNF next to it?
Exactly. That's the main thing. I mean, if you can finish a race, yeah, a bent ball joint's going to affect the handling, but it works a lot better than a broken one. A broken ball joint, usually they happen on corner entry, and when that happens, you have zero steering, zero braking, and you're just along for the ride.
And that's the type of feature then that allows the wheel to leave the car.
Yeah, sometimes. Yeah, that's never good. And you know, not a lot of people think about the ball joint studs, and you know, they're kind of a simple looking design, but that heat treating, that's where all the magic really comes from.
Right, absolutely. Now, you know, going back to it being rebuildable, you know, what would someone expect time-wise? Like, you know, from start to finish, if they pull off the track in between the heat and the feature and they're looking to make a change, I mean, is it several minutes, you know, a half hour? What would someone expect to make a change on a pin, make a change on, you know, one of the different items with the
sure.
ball joint?
Well, the main thing, all you really need is the ball joint toolkit. We have the spanner socket that fits into the jam nut on the ball joints, and you need a 1-inch wrench or a socket to fit the hex on here. And then we have a hollowed out Allen wrench that fits over the greaser. You don't have to take that out, and that
nice.
Unscrews a ball joint and the stud pops right out. So if you're in a hurry, I mean, realistically, you can change out a stud after a heat race before your tires have even cooled off.
Really?
Oh yeah, there's really, I would say maybe 3 to 5 minutes total time start to
wow.
finish.
Wow, that's awesome. That's awesome. Well, that's really cool. I'm glad we're able to, you know, talk about the subject. It's not a subject that I think, you know, we spend a lot of time on talking about, but there are some true advantages here to the racer who's interested in a low friction ball joint. Something that's more performance minded, obviously, takes the bind out of the suspension, like you said, allows the shock and spring to do their job without being,
exactly.
I guess, impacted by another area of the suspension. It's got the strength characteristics, so you know it's going to be strong, but also with some careful thought into the failure mode in event of an accident, which again, we don't try to do, but sometimes mm-hmm. things happen.
Mm-hmm.
These are designed to keep you going around the track and finish the race.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And just, you know, if anybody's ever felt a stock ball joint or a ball joint you buy at your local parts store, try to move the stud by hand and you'll see how difficult that is. And
right.
then multiply that by four. You have four ball joints on the car, and that's an incredible amount of bind that your front suspension has to overcome before the shocks will even work.
Right.
You know, and that on a dry, slippery track or a slippery asphalt track, that bind can be impossible to overcome.
No, that sounds cool. That sounds cool. Well, let's do this. Let's do a demonstration so people can see what it takes to disassemble and then reassemble a ball joint, if
sure.
you wouldn't mind.
Absolutely.
And give the viewer kind of a look into that.
Sure. All right, so to take apart one of these ball joints, what we want to do is flip it over, and we can see the jam nut here. Here is the spanner nut or spanner socket that fits on here. And then a 1-inch socket fits onto the hex or a 1-inch wrench. Take that off. All you have to do is crack it loose, and then it unthreads really easy. Just a jam nut. And then we take our hex key, and that fits over the zerk. You don't have to take the zerk out, into the hex, and then that unthreads just by hand, or you can put a 1/2-inch wrench on it. This is the torque nut that we're taking out. And this is actually what sets the preload on the stud. The tighter this is, the harder it is to move the stud. Unthread that. And then it's simply a matter of pushing the stud out. So here we have the stud, and here we have our combination steel spider and plastic cup. The plastic cup takes of really light loads, and then any high impact loads get supported by the steel spider. So if we want to put a longer stud in, we just reverse the process. So we put the stud in the ball joint, put our cup and spider in, and then just tighten everything back up. Thread our torque nut in. And you'll see if I thread that all the way down as tight as I can go, I can barely move the stud. This still isn't as bad as a stock ball joint, but we want to back that off a little bit. Then we run our jam nut down. Then we want to double check our preload once again. And when we're happy with that, we put the socket back on, put our hex key down through the middle, line that up with the hex, And then with a 1-inch open end wrench and a 1/2-inch open end wrench, you jam these two together, and that locks the preload in place and keeps that setting where you want it. And that's it. Now you have a new longer stud in your ball joint and you're ready to get back on track.
So there you have it. Thank you, Marshall, for walking us through the QA1 Ultimate ball joint. For more information on this, make sure to check out QA1.net. Make sure to hit the subscribe button here on these YouTube videos. A lot of good tech tips and different shops, tips and tricks and things of that nature coming your way. And make sure to follow us on social media. In the meantime, guys, go drive it. Ready?
Ready? All right. Ready? Do I look at you at the start or the camera?
I don't care.
All right.
You're overthinking this.
All right, I am. All right, I'm ready.
You know, this is all gonna feed into the bloopers at the end. Just be aware.
You're recording now?
Yeah.
It's a whole lot of low friction cut. I don't know what I was saying there.